Ending Binge, the first ride, is still 2 years into the future, but the Cincinnati Streetcar wants its identity solidified this year. WLWT News Source John London is live for us tonight with a look at the project's latest hurdle. Hi there, John.
Yeah, Cherie, Cincinnati, a big branding town, and more than 30 requests for proposals are expected within the next 10 days. All competing to give the streetcar, which is being built behind me here and over the Rhine, a certain look, its own logo.
As light work continued on the Cincinnati streetcar line today, the heavy lifting of identity and image began inside Metro offices.
What we call daffodil yellow, it's a very bright yellow, orangey kind of color. People see different colors a little bit when they see that.
What you see and connect with is what Metro's working on now for the streetcar. Much like the logo it designed for its bus identity 9 years ago, Metro sees the need for some memorable streetcar branding.
Where will the logos go? And
that will be determined once we have them.
Metro's asking 30-some local branding companies to come up with their best vision for a streetcar logo. They want something to hang their image on by the end of summer. The streetcar opponents are aghast.
Why do they have to market the streetcar? The proponents told us this was so good that people would just flock to the streetcar. Now they must have some doubts.
Not so, Metro counters. America's all about logos, so branding the streetcar is a logical necessity. The cost is described as modest, meaning several thousand dollars, already built into a federal grant.
So, no additional monies being spent on the logo. We are told that the idea of branding the streetcar to give it its own identity has been in the plan since Jump Street. Reporting live and over the Rhine, John London, WLWT News 5.
All right, John, thank you. Metro plans to select the logo design firm in June. It wants the final product ready for use by the end of the summer.